excuse me, I would say that doesn't work because there are no letters like that connected to the crab. Yet, that is what you know. You know that from England. And the two charterhouses started when there were no two at all in this world. If you can figure that they attribute to Abraham as being the first Jew, or Hebrew, or Haribu, any of those names, you cannot then have any Hebrew before Abraham. In some language, we call it Ibrahim, and also Abraham. And that would be at best. The Egyptians are in the 14th dynastic period, or I can say rather than Egyptian because that would come from the Greek Egyptus and from the English Egyptian. We will go back to Cameria and Cameria's, and some will come later to a later period in which they're speaking of the black earth in terms of Egypt. I am not speaking of none of that. I am speaking from the beginning of the Egyptian calendar. And that too will be from a change. The Egyptian, most common Egyptian calendar which we refer to is 10,000 BC. Well, that will cost you a lot of problems because I'm speaking to what I don't mean. Take your time and listen to what I'm saying. I am speaking before Adam and Eve. You see, who gave us Adam and Eve? Adam and Eve come from the Hebrew Bible, the book of Genesis. But the Hebrews came long after we, the Egyptians, were in history. They came in 1675 before another person called Jesus Christ, or Jesus the Christ. Jesus, the man, or Joshua, the Christ, the anointed. That's all. That the name of the man was called in ancient time, and now in modern time, you have made Christ a name. You don't speak of the Christ anymore. So that I say, you have to get yourself properly orientated to understand the manner in which you are speaking is Western. It doesn't relate to anything Eastern, or at least when I say Eastern, I would say up to the Eastern part of Africa. I don't know if you want to call it Eastern or not, but for the sake of argument, I'm going to use that. So we must understand, when I speak of Egypt, I am speaking at the northeast corner of the continent of Akebola, or if you want to call it Ortega, or you want to call it Hamonis, or you want to call it Hamonis, either of those names, the 15 names in which the ancients referred to Africa, but you use only one, the Greek way, Africilla, A-F-R-I-C-L-A, and then you change it to Africa with a K, and then you change it to the C, but nevertheless, it has nothing to do with that man, although we use it commonly. But if you say Al-Kabbalah, then you will be dealing with the land. We deal with everything. For instance, I'll give you an example. I would go to you one time ago and I'd chop me. And if I didn't call you Negro, you're mad. And if I didn't call you color, you're mad. There are many things that you adopted that comes from, please respect me, I have only one first to this, that comes from master. And when the master said something, we commonly do it. We wear clothes that the master has given us. We set standards. We do all kinds of things. We even raise our children the way the master has said, and then James boys come, you don't change just when he changes, he does that. We can't deny that. So let me get back to the most important thing. You speak of the grand blood of Lobster. And the grand blood of Lobster was built by Pharaoh Amenhotep III. Moses wasn't born yet. Moses, you alleged for you, Moses was during the time have the favor to talk to them. We can put in for a period of time. That is way when the fairs of all kinds, when the Grand Lodge was opened long before that, when the first Grand Lodge at Saqqara was opened long before that. You're speaking about the time of Dusa, you know, Tep, and all kinds of different people. You're talking about the multi-genius of our country. Therefore, it is important that you come to Egypt. If nothing else, to see the Grand Lodge and to see the original Lodge. It's still there. Broken down, yes, but nevertheless still there. For example, if I had said to your brethren that tonight James Brown would be playing, it would have been bad.
That's right.
You would not have been able to get anybody at all in here. But I am speaking to you about the crowd. And you can see the kind of presentation. Not only to that, but then speak. See, it's hard to speak to people when they're in a different frame of mind. But we could not speak to you tonight. And for that reason, you notice that I haven't dressed appropriately. I couldn't speak with you, with ladies who are of your craft, because we didn't have women in our craft. We don't have an auxiliary group. Women have an order that could be said to be similar to the craft in its context. But nevertheless, they never meet with us, or we with them, because we can never be women and they can never be men. So you have to understand the standard by which I am going to speak to you tonight is based upon quadrants. For example, you based upon a compass to measure a circle or to circumscribe a circle. And within the circle, we have four quadrants. One quarter, second quarter, third quarter, fourth quarter. You must start the first quarter at age 7. You must finish the last quarter, which is the fourth quarter, by age 70. And it has nothing to do with sound or saying anything. What about the picture? You know, it didn't exist. When the third craft was initiated, he wasn't existing. When the first pyramid was built, Abraham wasn't born. When this 97, which is the last pyramid, the one down at Marab, when that was built, Abraham was born. When Egypt built her last pyramid, Abraham wasn't born. She built the last pyramid, the 12th dynasty. Abraham was born to the 13th dynasty when he was born. If in fact there is an Abraham. Now, a lot of things I have to say will be hard to you, because we have to first understand there are many religions in the world. You said you got the only one and it was Jesus. Another one said he got the only one and it's with Allah. Another one said he got the only one, it's with Jehovah. But none of those three was in existence when the ancient Egyptian was worshiping Ra and continued to worship Ra. The reason we don't worship Ra, most of us today, is because of colonialism has forced us to accept new values. But some of us still worship old values and have the pride based upon the worship of Ra. You are going to argue
Which is correct.
Now, if I came here and I said, I want to join the crowd, you say, okay. And then you will put me through a rhythm of Jesus Christ. And I said to you, I can't do that because we have a Christ before you. And the wall at Abydos, he has been to Abydos, at least I know that. You will go to the wall and find goddess Aset, otherwise called Isis. You see God as a root, otherwise called Osiris. And you will see God Heru, otherwise called Horus. They are 4,000 years before Jesus Christ. Yes. And their mother Aset, had a baby by an immaculate conception. This is 4,000 years before Jesus Christ. In her own world, she had it at the city of Abydos, which is the first holy land. There was no Palestine yet. There was no Jerusalem. There was no Mecca. This is thousands of years before any of those three names. So there you have a story that has been compounded, that has been followed, but it has become the standard. We have been introduced to many concepts by our slave masters who have not taken into consideration any of our civilization because they need to make us less than themselves. Let me go by one by one. If I came to you, don't I say I'll leave. If I came to you, I will speak a little in tongue. If I came to you and I greet you, you will greet me as a man in three dimensions. You will give me the word in triple method. And we would say and give the grip. And you would say that you're a man. However, if you came to me and gave me three dimensions, I would say, okay, you've done very good, but you need four more to be a man. And you would say to me, four more than that, I would be up in a big house. And I say, no, four more than that would be showing me that you are a man. Anything less than that, you cannot speak to me at that level. You can't speak. You will say, all I need to be is three. And I said, no, you need seven. And so you couldn't speak to me. And then we are ready to fight. We're ready to have an argument. We're ready. And then I have to tell you, did you read the Book of the Dead? And and 10 to 1, you have not read it. Because if you look at the picture, you see yourself in there. And then look at what it is, look at where it came from, and look at how many copies are in the world. And you will see things in which you would be shocked. Because then I cannot speak to you, not through your fault, but through our colonization by the European. Many other things which you hold to. Let's take even your behavior, your marching in the street. You said, I am a member of a secret society. How secret could you be when I saw you in the street with a top hat, a crow's tie, a cutaway jacket? There's no African I know ever dressed that way. Huh? But you're dressed that way, and you're well dressed, because it's dark, white, dark. Thank you. But I can't recognize you.
And I said, I see a secret organization. How come I see him in the street with an organization with a name? And then you go to the extent of having a brother, you say, is a brother, in fact, when you imitate another religion, you say he's a shrine. And you, all you do with him is to make joke of another man's religion. The difficulty is that since you have not studied the Book of the Dead or the Papyrus of Ani and many other books, for instance, the Book of Knowing Ra, the Book of Gates, all of these books are older than Genesis. You can't get Adam and Eve in there because there are no Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve was only for those who are Judeo, Christian, and Islamic. But what happened about the religions before that? And namely, if you were of the region, any of the regions in Egypt, Ethiopia, and not necessarily, but Egypt, Sudan, and Ethiopia, and Uganda. But you will know Egypt, Sudan, Ethiopia from the time of the British occupation of those lands. But I'm speaking before the British, before the missionaries came. And you have not come to you see. You will go to Israel, you will go to Mecca, and you will go to Rome, but you will not come home to see us. So let me speak about it. Let me speak to you on the first quadrant. When you meet the first quadrant and the bulk of the work that you need to do, you will have to come to Ethiopia to the stone, and to Egypt to the stone, and to Sudan to the stone. But the first step is Egypt at the end of the Nile. Not the beginning of the Nile. The Nile does not flow from the north to the south. It flows from the south to the north. The Blue Nile comes out of Ethiopia. The White Nile comes out of Uganda. And we are talking about when Ethiopia was called another name, Axum. And when Uganda was called Buganda, and it was part of the Buganda Kingdom. The Blue Nile and White Nile meet as Khartoum and join together. They flow out of Khartoum still northwards and meet another body of water coming out of Ethiopia. When it meets that body of water, it then flows still north, but it has passed a number of cataracts. So the first cataract is in Sudan instead of in Egypt. And it then goes all the way until it meets the sixth cataract in Egypt, in a place called Sono, which is today called Aswan. Then it continues down all the way to where Alexandria is, the end of Egypt in the north, and flows in the great sea, which you call Mediterranean. Now you see all that, but there is more, because you have to come to the first quadrant. If I said to you, are you a man? You said, I am a man. I said, how do I know? You said, try me. And then I tried you. And I try you because you said you are a man. I don't have to try you from A to B or to C or Z. I may try you anyway within seventh level. That is just for you being a man, but you are walking in the first quadrant. So then I ask you, if you are a man, you have already been to the stone. You know what kind of stone I'm speaking about? I said, I am talking about the stone at the temple in Aswan. If you have met, but you tell me, I've been to Israel. I've been to Rome, I've been to Athens, but you still haven't yet said, I was home. Is it natural for a person to go to his home if you never know your mother, says she had given you away if something happened? Isn't the first thing when you get your alleged freedom, you want to meet your mother? Instead of going to see somebody else? No, you go to see somebody else than your mother. Because you have not been told that you are a man. You need somebody to tell you are a man. You're supposed to know, because you're now a father. You're a father of a daughter, father of a son of many. So you don't need anyone to tell you are a man. You have all the proof that is necessary. You're born with women, you're having children, so you are a man. Or at least, you're somewhat like a man. Now, at the 12th pyramid, what Herodotus came from Greece in 450, before the common era, and he saw a building. He described it in his book. It is the labyrinth. And the 12th pyramid. And there is no pharaoh more African in looks than this particular pharaoh. This pharaoh is Amen-Hat the third. Amen-Hat the third. He just moved out of the museum. They put the statue to begin, because it's 12. And this building had 3,000 rooms, 1,000 of them below the earth's surface. There was a trap, and when you go there, you will see evidence of the trap, you see evidence of the footings that they raised up, and of course, a part of the pyramid still remains. Unfortunately, it's now a lot of water, a lot of water. You can't go inside. It's now inside. Because before the great pyramid, the dam was built, the water table was a certain level, but since the dam has built, the water table has increased about 4 feet. To ask people to understand the relationship of the craft between here and there is difficult, because you're asking us to accept Western terminology, Western ideologies, Western behavior about something that isn't there. And you will not make the move to break away. You are making the rule to coalesce. And that's the difficulty. For instance, when we speak of the Pharaoh, you have in your mind that the Pharaoh must have been bad, because you have the story of a story by the Hebrews saying the Pharaohs were bad. Did you have a book by the Pharaoh written by an Egyptian saying that the Egyptians were good? Or do you have only a book in which the Hebrews said the Egyptians were bad? You say, in law, that there's one story must have more than just the complainant. It must have the respondent. But you made the complainant, witness, judge, jury, and everything. And you listen to his side, but don't listen to the respondent. So it is hard. I am wearing a ring. You may proceed from there. You can see an American dollar bill. And in dollar bill, you have a pyramid. As a matter of fact, it's the Great Pyramid at Giza, the largest of the pyramids of Giza. There were 16 pyramids originally there, but when the Arabs came as conquerors in Egypt 1300 years ago, one of the things they did was to use all these sculptures from the various ancient sites and took the stones within it to build house for the Wazir, not only the Arabs, the Christians and the Jews, all who were there, paid no interest to the fact that those institutions were Egyptian, were African. And they destroyed them. Many in different degrees, some completely. And therefore, it is hard for us to give a full accounting, but yet there's more than those with the most money. You have to have gone to Egypt before, even the first quadrant, the stone is about the only thing that damaged. But when you go there, you must be able to go at an early period in which you and the brother agree to go to be there so that there will not be men past 70 years of age, women of any age at all. And now you're going to say something else. Since your wife is going to say to you, you cannot treat us different to you, we are human beings. And we will say to you, so what? You can't understand that because you have already women in your craft. You are women yourself. The female cannot open a house without one of you. And you become a woman for that crap. Now how do you support it? I do not know. But I know at no time of week we need to decide we will throw a woman. Alright. To understand the recent crap, you must understand first of all what we are doing. The craft came about in the building of the first building of stone ever built by a human being. The Great Pyramid, the Step Pyramid of the Pharaoh Djoser. Not Z-O-Z-E-R, that's the Greek spelling. D-J-O-S-E-R. The architect was a mountain genius in Hotep. He was a builder, an architect, and equally a physician, the prime minister. He had a number of things that he did. And this was the third dynasty. Not a single Jew was born anywhere yet. Not Abraham was born. He isn't born until the 14th dynasty. We are talking about the first dynasty to the 14th dynasty. And there was Egypt before the dynastic period. There was Egypt during the civilian period, civilian first, second, and third. That would bring us to 10,000 when we started the religion that we have there. The belief system was started at 10,000 when we worshiped the moon, we looked at the moon in a different perspective. It is 4,100. That we changed and decided is the sun should be given the worship, because every day the sun, if it doesn't shine here, it shines somewhere else. But it's going to shine every day. You can bet the dollar. You can't bet on Jesus Christ. Because something they're going to say about Jesus Christ, you can't prove it to me every day. But I can prove to you every day that the sun is shining. So, theory. It started when Imhotep wanted a place to bury his pharaoh. That's the third dynasty. Up until then, they buried the pharaoh in the ground in a box-like housing around it. Imhotep tried to make a box out of the stone structure. Stonemason without marble. He didn't like the first box,
a square.
He made a second box smaller than the first, a third smaller than the first two, a fourth smaller than the first three, a fifth like a wedding cake, until there are six boxes. The Egyptian called them mastaba. Mastaba is the box like structure. And 80% in the earth and 20% out. It is in Hotep who built that first stone structure, and then it was necessary to build a valley temple. To build a burial temple and to build an embalming temple with a tunnel that connect them all. Not only that, the body was set 91 feet down into the ground, 91 foot deep. So by the first period of time when he started that, the pharaoh lay deep into the ground, because the first belief was heaven was down in the earth. But by the fourth dynasty, the bodies are up on the second floor. We are then at Giza, where they start to build their pyramids. It also at the fourth dynasty in Giza, when they would take a mountain, a piece of mountain, and build or design what they call today the Sphinx of Giza, which we who relate to it know it as another name. We know it as Hamakis. But Hamakis is a Greek name. So we go back to what? The third pharaoh of the fourth dynasty, and we call it by that name. And that's to worship the statue of the god of Khufu, Khafre, Amenkhra. We call it the statue of Khafre. It is the head of a human being, the body of a lion, and everything else pertaining to the lion. Most of the veil has gone and the lips have gone because they attributed destruction to Napoleon the Bonaparte, and the various people have come in there, they attributed the destruction, but only the nose and part of the veil. So when you come, if you came there in the first quadrant, you would have had to go to stone, and I can't tell you what, but you would have to come there and present yourself in the presence of your brothers alone. Nobody else. And you have to take an oath to somebody, nobody else. And you would then be brought in under first quadrants. From then, after accepting somebody and then brought in on the first quadrant, you can then work. Now, you can use jewelry. Your jewelry must be 18 karat or better. And then you can speak, because no cross. Have no crosses. Because there's no Jesus here. That's going way later before you have something called Jesus. You can't talk about John the Baptist, because every Pharaoh was baptized. Every Pharaoh. And every Pharaoh to the last Pharaoh was before Jesus Christ. All the Pharaohs are before the Christian era. Jesus is the Christian era. Jesus started Christianity. And therefore, you cannot speak about the virginity, because there is the virginity of Aset, Isis. And that was given to her by the god Amun-Ra, who she appealed to when her husband was killed. Again, you know, when you're talking about a god being killed. You see, you talk about the one miracle. Well, Osiris was killed twice. Osiris was first hanged. His killer, his brother. His brother see him for the second time and cut him up now. Besides, this time I'll get rid of you. Cut him up in 14 pieces. Throw away each piece around the world, and the last piece is penis. Throw it into the Nile River, and the Nile catfish. That's what I mean, catfish. The Nile catfish ate it, and as a result, Lupia is the only catfish. But again, so you see, all in there. But looking into it, you can find that way back there, when this is the papyrus of Ani, giving you what will happen before you go into hellfire. Now, you speak all the time about hellfire. And the hellfire, there are six forces that turn the hellfire on. You were taught that you'll be constantly beaten for the right when after you die, that God will come there with a stick as a monster and beat you and mistreat you and put some non-cooking water so you don't cook too much and beat you and do anything to you. That's what you've been taught. With all the billions and trillions of people that have been born, how many gods you got? They're going to come and beat you. They're looking there and there. Remember, this is older than the Jewish Bible. Thousands of years older. Genesis of the Jewish Bible was not started until 700 BC. This goes back to 4100 BC, 4100 years before Genesis. And yet, we have this day. And I'm sure that you didn't know. And your Bible speaks of this book. It speaks of the book of the dead. And the papyrus of Ani, but never showed you a copy. But here it is, book of the dead and papyrus of Ani. Why? There's more, no more than saying that you are inferior by virtue of your being. Not that you have done anything, just say. And to satisfy their position, you satisfy the statement by being bad. Or at least pretending to be mad, because bad people always got somebody worse coming up. But these are the things that we have to look at. Number one, how can you be independent of a person, yet that person decides how you're going to eat, how you're going to sleep, how you're going to die, and how you're going to be better? To be independent, you must have independent thoughts of him and independent things that you do. Yes, you can go to a school. I went to a school. All of us. It's not. But when you become a man, you do other things if you haven't done it yet. There are all kinds of schools, all kinds of beliefs, all kinds of lands you can travel and visit, all kinds of religion that you can read, and all kinds of religion you can be amongst to know what's right or wrong. But no, you said, it's got to be right that. And you take it and don't listen to anybody else say anything. You won't hear no one else at all. This is the problem. In the first quadrant, again, it is dealing with the most eastern part of Al-Kebulan, Abaska. Therefore, it's dealing with Somalia. Somalia as a part of Penwet. Penwet, which was called Puanito Penwet. Then the Jews came and call it by another name. So you decide if the Jews call it by another name, it's got to be right. So you call it Punt. Punt does not exist. This is a part in Africa. They had never been to Punt. The Jews never went there. They heard about the name and thus used this to speak of an African nation. But up until the 25th dynasty, it was Tahaka, our pharaoh, our the head of Egypt, Ethiopia, and Sudan. His name is Tahaka. He was the king that saved Israel from the Assyrians taking it over. He is the king that they run to save Israel. You don't know, you have not studied that. This is as much a fact that you must be acquainted with as you are acquainted with the food and your plate in the morning. Because if you have to discuss with people who you are, you must know some historical data. Just as you tell me, Cleopatra was a black woman, and I will ask you where. You will tell me Cleopatra was a black woman in Egypt. I said, what Egypt? I got to ask you what Egypt, because it's going to be a different Egypt than I know. You mean number one, Cleopatra is seven. That's another thing. You got to lose number. And if you tell me Cleopatra is seventh, who was the woman of Egypt messing with Antony, Mark Antonio, of Europe, Rome, who married a woman? This is the woman that you are very in tune with. The history of Mark Antonio, he married Caesar's sister. Went to bed with Caesar's sister, did not sleep with her, but went through the window to go back to Cleopatra in Egypt. And that's why Caesar was mad. And number one, she is not black. How did you get her black? She is the daughter of Sutter, who changed his name to Ptolemy when the death of Alexander, and called himself Pharaoh of all Egypt. Her mother was the daughter of the Persian Sarah, who had lost the war because Persia had enslaved both Egypt and Greece. So her mother is white, she's a Persian. Her father is white, a Greek, Macedonian Greek. How did you get her back? It was Cleopatra the first to Cleopatra the seventh. It was Ptolemy, all the boys were Ptolemy. Ptolemy the first to Ptolemy 15. Now you name which one of them Ptolemies was black. Which one of the Persians, Terap's wife, was black. Name me one. You don't know. But you said she was. Who told you she was? You said it because you liked it? It was a time when we wanted to know that certain blacks were like Donna Shaw. You said Donna Shaw was black. Because you wanted to be that way, not that she was black. You got no proof. But you wanted it to be so. So as long as you want it, that's all. But the proof isn't there to support you. Just like this. Sure, it is true that Cleopatra was Greek Persian and not a bit of African in her. Mm. That to her, because I'm busting your balloon.
Cleopatra is
like the girl that's just coming from England, just divorced the prince from England, the crown prostitute. I mean, if you have claimed somebody of consequence, we could understand. But there's so many great African women, queen and not queen, who were great people you could admire and pay tribute to, that we are suffering when you call Cleopatra, and when you should have left her where you found her. It's good she had left to kill herself. we are very glad to come to Cleopatra. But why is it that they want you? Because of the same book. When they came to Egypt, they found, among other things, the first houses built by men out of brick, out of stone. They found a medical profession in a schoolroom
with doctors.
They found a society in which you entered medical school and all other different school at age 7, and you did not complete your education until age 47. This nonsense about mystery school, we had no mystery school. We had an educational system which produced some people that the Greeks call mysterious. It was mysterious because what we were teaching, they didn't know. And it was a mystery to them. Mathematics, engineering, science, medicine, all that. And they had come to learn. And we had been in existence for thousands of years before Crete, the island between Greece and Egypt. And then we went to Crete, taught the Cretans, and the Cretans went and became the first Europeans. That is why you see so many Africans like us in Greece. We feel proud. You know, you could be in bondage and still be proud, because they can put in bondage anybody. We feel proud because of our history, and we have no doubt that we will come back. You can mistreat me, it's like some brothers, you mistreat the wife, you beat her up in the morning, but you try to go to sleep with her in the night. Right? She indicates to you that you're less than her. Because if you beat her in the morning, but gotta go to bed with her in the night, she's better than you. You have to give up that false pride where you declare she's nothing, you can beat her up, and go to her to get her body. By the time you're ready to beat her, ready to go. If you hit her, you gotta be ready to go. Because you're hitting her by showing your contempt for her. You can't love her and beat her at the same time. Mm-hmm. It is the big argument. And the first quadrant again, when you are in the first quadrant, you go to, remember, God is a belief. You don't know God. Not you, none of you. I don't care who you are. I don't care if you're the Pope. You don't know God. You believe in a God. And one belief is just as good as that. But taking that to what it's worth is your relationship with man and woman, of course, that make you important or unimportant. What you've done with man or woman, your relationship with that is what is going to make you the great person you're supposed to be. Maybe you are. In looking at the book again, when you come to the second quadrant, I will not go into any of the quadrants at any length because you understand. I don't know even the men, if you are man or woman. I don't know if you have taken the oath. So I use caution.
Go ahead.
In the second quadrant, you will have to go to Sudan for this. You go to Sudan because you have to go to the necessary place. You see, the Jews said that they build the pyramids of Egypt. Oh, we don't need to go to that. Of stone, of brick made of mud and straw. You go, I will take you to all the pyramids, and you don't see a brick made of straw. In not one of the 97 pyramids. But did they build those in Sudan too? There are 44 pyramids in Sudan. And you got to walk, and they had something. And it's not a blanket plugged into the wall. I am talking about walking under something. And the pyramids That thing around, I mean, that thing is blown around the pyramid, and then at night you sleep in Tukonde, one of the cities in Sudan. And then when you go there, in your condition, you will not be feeling good, I'm sure. You got to drive 5.5 hours from Sudan going northeast till you meet Baga. And in Baga, you will meet the first collective of buildings run by Queen Shaba Taka Shaba. And you will see her killing her enemies, etc. And a complex of buildings there. And you ask, what I thought it was only in Egypt that they had these buildings. You thought. But you don't know. And then you travel 5 more hours going to Meroe. You're going to Meroe because you're going to stand in the pyramid circle in Meroe. That's 5 hours plus 2 hours. You are already 7 hours in the desert going, and now you reach Meroe. But when you reach Meroe and look around you, what you have seen, 10 people live here, 20 people live there, 30 people live there, you're fast on the way, and that's all they live. And there's no store, you can't buy a big bottle of beer. And those people live there all year around. And all they ever see is sand, and more sand. And you have to go to see that. And as I said, nothing is punched in the wall, and a pit open to walk on. That's in your second quadrant. I just give you something. You must now sleep in Tukonde one night. And as you sleep in Tukonde that night, you will get up and get ready to drive back 7 hours non-stop to Tukonde. You have to Sudan now. You have gone to Ethiopia to the third quadrant. In Ethiopia, you're now coming to what they call the Christian era. And you have a set of buildings at Lalibaba, a set of churches that cut in the mountain. They're not built, they're cut out with tools that man cut it out with a hand, hatching and hammers. There are 10 on top and 10 below. Of the 10 below, one is down to the ground. These are things, there is no step for you to walk up. I can't tell you what. It's on, you're walking, but it's on the side of the mountain. You can't come back because there are others coming behind you. You must go forward. You will notice that there are blind men. Blind men who are walking behind you in all this treacherous place. And Arabians. And you wonder, in the buildings you will see everything. And then you finish these 10 stone buildings lined up, and then it takes you down to the lower place where there are 10 other buildings. And in the 10 other buildings, now, the Egyptians, the Ethiopians have taken the ancient town and turned over to Christianity by saying that some stone from Solomon given to Hakim is the only stone and the stone of Moses. There is not a thing. In Egypt, there is a stone of the confined one at Edfu, where Horus the Elder is. And this is an exact copy, but they can't show you. They tell you they keep it because of a miracle. What miracle? Show them. Show the people what you got. But they can't show. is that we as Africans, whatever we have, we are ashamed of it, though it is higher than others. And those of us who run the various governments have been to the schools of the masters. We've been to school in Belgium, school in France, school in America, school in Russia, school in Italy, you name it, we've been there as a student. And leave our own school and come back and feel that the foreign education is there. Just to feel, and you ask, why have Africans behaved so badly in fighting each other? Because we are not Africans. We look like it. Like you. Ask yourself, look at yourself good, and ask yourself, am I an African? When last did I call myself an African? And you know better than I would myself, I just call myself an African just that of me. It is because we have been trained to look thoroughly against our craft. If the Europeans decided in the morning they're going to end masonry, there'll be no masonry, you're going to end it. You're 3 months later and you will end yours. At one time you had a white girl who was Miss Prince Albert. You'll excuse that she was black in mind, even not in heart. What nonsense that is. She black, she white. And when a black girl went in the white Miss America, you know something wrong with you. It's gotta be wrong. You see, nobody likes to be condemned, but I don't condemn, just the same. Because it is time, you had Garvey here, you had Malcolm here. I don't hear the name. I only hear King. There must be something wrong. That you don't accept those that the white men accept. If you produce leaders going back to the past, the great reverends who fought for our freedom, you don't accept them if they have not been accepted by whites. The Masonic craft must speak of three individuals, and you say that you go to look for them. These are men. One was found in Ethiopia, and you tell me that you have a name with three syllables, and that one, and one of them was Abomu. And you tell me, you say that because that man was one of them. And a third was the beginner. And you say you went to look for them down in Ethiopia, and you only found the decay formation. That will be in the second degree. And when you come back to the second degree, you can now go to the third degree. You are going now from Ethiopia, but you are going to some place that you would consider the people uncivilized because they don't live like you. But they live their life, an African life. I'm talking about Uganda. I am in Uganda. And there's quite a big fall there. And you said it's the Queen Victoria Lake. Now how Queen Victoria get a lake in Africa? She don't have a lake in England. And you give her a lake in Africa. Do you see how some point is some? We have a name for the lake. And we always speak of it as Mwanza Nyanza. So we all gone back to Mwanza Nyanza. Now that Queen Victoria, of course, is out there. When in the lion mouth, you have to speak like the lion. You got no choice. But when you're outside of the lion mouth, you speak as a man.
We will do our third degree there.
And we will do it
exactly at the lake.
Because there are certain African words to be said about the crab. And the crab has nothing to do. And that's why I said, when you brag that Prince Hall was given the degree,
he's the son of an Englishman and an African woman. So well, they give him a degree and you're happy.
There's nothing to be happy about. He was given partially what the crab had had in Egypt. England and France had stolen, and now given to the colonies of African people who they had conquered. And we don't feel proud of it.
It's unfortunate, but we don't feel proud.
Now, of course, the fourth degree is the big degree. You have to be in Ethiopia at Lalibela. In Lalibela, you will see all kinds of structures. Nowhere else in the world you're going to see them. And you will see what we have done with our two hands. And people come and now say it must have been done by men from outer space. The pyramids must have been done by men from outer space. The churches in Ethiopia from men from outer space. At Lalibela, outer space. And all this. And then they go to see the most ancient relics we have in an ancient city. Because they can't figure the writing there. Because they cannot figure how could we have made those sheets of stone, and they want to know what kind of tools we use. I'm so glad they can never find it. And then all of us trying to explain to them how it was done. And I'm saying, why explain? Haven't we explained enough? But we continue. You must understand again that you must come familiar with this book. If you come home to fight your battle, because in the crab, you cannot drink alcohol and know that one word lack. You cannot drink alcohol and mistreat a brother, a brother's wife, a brother's sister, a brother's mother, any relative of a brother. It is enough to remove you from Christ. But then you must stand for those principles. We point to the ever-seeing eye, the ever-seeing eye of Horus. When he had to fight his uncle, Sir Ivan. That is the most ancient of religious philosophical thought that there is. And we were told to not look at this. Don't believe in it. Why? It was before they, thousands of years before they had theirs. If it was good for us to build all those temples, to build all that we build, the pyramids and so forth, it still is good today. So although we do not, at the most, worship in those temples, although we do not do many things in the open, although we do not march in the street, we still maintain our integrity in these values. The values that go back thousands and thousands upon years. The concept, let me give you a virgin birth. I was born with a virgin birth. Maybe you were. I don't know. Can't check you out. My mother had me, my father, that's her statement to me. And the man she pointed to me, she told me that's my father. And she had no intercourse with another man until I was born. Now, if that is true, I am the virgin of birth. No man touched me but my father. You got the virgin birth, meaning a complete different thing. You are saying that the woman had never been touched by a human being. It did not say that. It said the Greek word virgo is a clean woman. And a woman who goes with no one else but her husband is a clean woman. And she has a virgin child. It has nothing to do with the condition of her hymen. Mm. It could be big, small, like a house. But we have made the mistake, and the virgin birth has nothing to do with Jesus. It has to do with Mary. Mary was born to her mother without the benefit of childbirth, of intercourse. That's what they're trying to fool us with. The feast of the Immaculate Conception is not of Jesus, is of Mary's birth to her mother. Actually, from a Catholic priest. Then he going to ask you where you come to with that. He said, because I read it. And that's what I'm talking about, is the trickery in which we are placed at. I know it hurts a lot of you because you don't want to hear the truth. The truth hurts. I know it. I don't like to hear truth either when it's against me. But I gotta live with it. I gotta deal with it. And let me take another point here. If tomorrow I came to you, and I came to you dressed as I am, or I came to you dressed the way any one of you are, and I give you the necessary sign, and you are in the process of a meeting, you will not answer me. You will not return my challenge to you, because you will say that I do not have on the right clothes. Any clothes I have on, if I'm naked, and I give you a sign, you must recognize my sign. I don't need papers or anything. My sign, if I know the sign, you must give it recognition. If I know the grip, you must give it recognition. And heaven knows. If I know the word, you must give it better recognition. But you will not do it. Because in the West, you are told by the clothes you wear. It shows that you're a brother. No. The clothes you wear shows nothing. It shows you got a clothes, that's all. It is by the sign, the word, and the grip.
That's right.
But we have lost that. And now I'm saying to you, go to Egypt once. One more. Go and see the Grand Lodge of Luxor. You speak of it, it's in your book. I am not telling you to do something you're not bound to do. I am saying to you, to go to Waset. The Greek story is Thebes. The British story and the Arab story is Luxor. But I'm using the original name, it's Waset. And you will go there and see the same thing that your house is built upon. You will go there and there. You can't find it in Israel. You can't find it. You can't find the Salomon house. The map of can't find Salomon house. Thousands of years before Solomon. I am asking you, at what point do we start? I mean, you're comfortable. I'm not trying to disturb your comfort. But at what point do you start being a man? At what point? Don't tell me my woman and I are the same. No, hello, she got a vagina and you got a penis. It's impossible for you to be the same. She got two breasts that are quite different than yours, and they're the same. See a doctor.
something more.
I mean, this is reality. You're afraid to be men.
I see going around there, jumping around. I
thought they said you're going to be a man doing all that stuff. You got faggot designing the clothes of men. Just look at them. Ladies can't pick up a dime if she drops it. She got to ask somebody to hire to pick it up. Because the whole family will be out of the house. These are realities. And the quicker we deal with reality, the better it's going to be for us. My brothers, I meant to tell you what I did tell you. With all honesty. And at times I feel that a little laughter may have come within. I came to the United States a few years ago with the United Nations. And I ended teaching at Cornell, for 18 years at Cornell University. But don't think I was happy. At the United Nations is a white man's organization, whether you like it or not. They run it for the benefit of white men, not for the benefit of the Africans. You could tell by their decisions. The men don't get stuck being prejudiced because you go to the United Nations. You don't stop president because get being prejudiced because you got a president. They're all prejudiced. I don't care if it's Carter or they're lined up over there. It is. One has to be a realistic. Two, we are an oppressed people. We're the best dressed up slaves there are. But we are in that condition because you can't tell me that we even have the same rights of privilege as Hebrew people, the white ones, because they're black ones. Hebrew people, you see the way we are treated in Israel, the 9 plus 4,000 in Israel, that's 13,000, and then those that existed there before the Europeans were brought into the country. Regardless of where we are around the world, we are mistreated by African people, but we are stupid because we have not yet decided to recognize each other. I'm an Ethiopian, you are Jamaican, he is a Trinidadian. The slave book did not bring Ethiopians, Jamaicans, Trinidadians. It brought Africans. It didn't bring Negroes, colored people, and Zambos. It brought Africans. And therefore, when the first African woman got a child in this part of the world, she got an African child. And we are still African. If we could recognize that, if we could recognize that the God we believe in is just as good or just as bad as the other God, and look at ourselves that need the help of each other, then we would have overcome most of the problem in our way to find a solution. And that we will go on. And fortunately, none of you within my voice can go to the fourth quadrant. You can't go because you didn't enter into the crowd at A7. Unfortunately, you got to be 70 years at oldest, 7 years at the youngest, to be a member of the crowd. 7 years, your father or your some elder brother has to take you in and stay with you to the legal age of the society, and then you continue and you will make the 70th and last quadrant. You got to, this conversion, you got to treat your wife. You stop and hear what I said, wife. Your wife, not the woman. If you got a woman, get rid of her. I said your wife. You must treat your wife as a part of yourself. Because we do not have any wife walking behind us. Our wife walks silent. And our wife works with us in harmony. Because it's impossible to have a girlfriend
And you're going away
unless you are living a polygamous life.
No understanding.
There's nothing wrong in having 10 women, 20 women, as long as they're 20 wives. Because in my place where I was born, my grandfather had 61 children and 11 wives. There was nothing wrong with it. Providing the country in which he lived, each wife is the same and is treated the same. Now you're going to say, they can't be treated the same. You never had 11 wives. But if you had, born in a society where multiple marriage is common and accepted, you will find no problem because each wife, if one has a car, the other one has to drive a car. You can't give one more than the other. And you can't hit your wife because she is a woman like you are a man. There are these values. There are all kinds of values. You can't see a burnt child in need of food and not give it. You cannot, because you'll be brought up and charged and you will be put out. There is no other way than to treat a brother who has refused food to a brother or a member of his family, but to expel him. And the worst thing is for nobody to speak to you. You see, in the craft, one is expected to be clean. Am I saying I'm clean? Yes. Am I saying that I make mistakes? Yes. But when I make a mistake and it's brought to my attention, I correct it. I immediately do everything to ask the person who I've hurt by that error to correct it, even though the bird is not on the grass. Because it's my duty, once a year, I ask all brothers, I make a statement when once a year, and ask any brother who I felt that I have offended to come and tell me and let me correct it. You don't do this. You don't ask the brothers and sisters, if they want, to explain to you what wrong you have done to them that you could have corrected. And these are things, and I think that is the very most important point that we need to do. Lastly, the book speaks of Annie meeting Osiris, who was a ruler. And so, as a rule, and his two sisters behind him, his two sisters are Aset. Anybody know the other one?
Nephritis.
Nephthys. And they're standing behind him. In front of him, in a certain plant, are the four sons of his grand of his son. And the four sons are there for anyone coming to him. Remember, Asaru, Osiris, was reborn before Jesus. Thousands of years before Jesus was born and come back and remove three stones, he had to move a wall. You don't know about it. But we have to read things that we do not accept, because in the world there are all kinds of things, and one can't say one is learned unless one is willing to accept, to read. Read anything. Read a book by Adolf Hitler. It is a book. Let no one tell you you can't read this, that, and other thing. It is the only way at times to know something else. To read. It will help you to learn. Reading doesn't make you accept it, but it makes you knowledgeable of it. Do not think
with your head like an ostrich from Ethiopia. Deep down in the sun, a big body. Here's the head in the sand, and a big body can take your aim and blow it away. That's why we call it the cuckoo bird. It's stupid. You, my brother, especially with the black studies going on today, it is necessary that you know as much as you can about yourself. Let no one know more than you. Don't mind if you're reading the same thing in the process at times. At least you're thinking that you're reading something different. Read and read and read until it hurts. You watch the TV. The time that you're putting this TV that's laughing your face out, you can put in serious writing. You can go back to see yourself, and that you like the King of England from the time of George III. Just notice who is his mother, Queen Charlotte Sophia. Look at that sister over there, and that's his mother. You read about the Three Musketeers, Alexander Dumas, the Dumas from France, that's you. You are all that you are talking about. You're talking about the first king of Sweden, that's you again. But that, from Haiti, it is you. You're talking about various people in Italy, and it's still you. Read of you when you were making the world what it's turned out to be. Read of you when men look up to you and call you the God of wisdom, God of that. Read the poems of Shakespeare, and you find that seven of Shakespeare's plays are writing about you. And that not, you have nothing to be ashamed of, but indeed to be proud of. You don't have to go to people and ask them, may I join you? Why? They should ask you, may I join you? Mm. You have nothing to fear. But we are times. We gotta stop and help each other. I have to come to you, you have to come to me. Where I have to listen to you, you have to listen to me. We need to talk to each other. And I would let it go to question and answer period. And sometimes I may not be able to answer your question for logical reasons that I will tell you. And other times I will answer your question. But one other night, when things occurred, and I got to say this, and with respect to the sisters who are listening to me, because I never be a sister, obviously. Nothing wrong with being a sister. I like them most pleasantly. What they are when they come. When the brothers are together, and when we can cross hands in the correct manner and meet in privacy, I will be able to share with you certain things that I can share now. And there are information that both of us can use. But in the interim, until time meets, I want you to go to the Grandad of Luxor, at least the Grandad of Luxor. With anyone, myself, somebody else, doesn't matter. And just as you enter, you will enter, and one side, Ramesses is there, Ramesses is there. And as you walk in, right beside the bar of Nehemiah, and the right hand side, and you turn backwards, you will see the temple just the exact way it's being walked. You would walk a few foot forward, and you look and you see the bird dressed in the regalia, with the apron and everything. And the right hand side, some of the birds without the head off, they fell in the earthquake. And then the regalia, you would stand up and see two major statues of Rameses II. And behind them, it is Tutankhamun and Amun-Ra. And then you see the hypostyle hall that goes up to the Holy of Holies in the back. And you would understand what it means. You would understand what it is to be a prophet. And then you would understand why it is nobody has been able to duplicate the temple at Warit, that's Kana. Temples within temples. You think that you have seen a temple when you saw the Vatican, when you saw St. John Divine, St. Patrick. You think you have seen. Put all of those in one place, all that I have mentioned, plus more, and still drive the Indy 500 around it. And there's a wall that wall these things in. You can stay from one end, and you can look as far as you want, you can't see that end. You did it. Your ancestors did it. You don't have nothing to be ashamed of. Look at the war and see the mathematics. And there was no Greece yet. It wasn't yet in history. It didn't exist before 1000 BC. And you were right in mathematics. When other men were not yet around, you were doing chemistry, medicine, building great buildings. Others were not around. There was no Jew yet. No Muslim, no Christian. But you were there. But you got to read books, all kinds of books. Like Stanley Lincoln's book. You got to go with Stanley Lincoln. You got to read all the other books. Including Book of Death, Book of Knowing Rock, Book of Gates, all those other books. Those are the ancient books of yourself, your parents' parents. And you don't have to be in a shape because you were enslaved. Every man on the face of this earth, his ancestors were enslaved one time or the other by somebody. Genghis Khan and his group were down in Europe. All the way to Austria. You don't hear them talking about their inferior. You answer to all the corrupt names, names of servitude, and forget your past. Yes, we all call to a man. We don't have to walk to a tomb. We have atoned already by our children suffering, and we were not meant to save them. So I open myself to your questions and answers.
You can get Book of the Dead. You can get
copies, the miniature copies of the Book of the Dead by Budge. And that will give you an exact copy of everything in there. But they don't, excuse me, they don't make the papyrus of Ani. They make it in different kinds of ways, but not like that.
For which you
say? 500 the world over.
So that's 1895 was the last time that they printed it.
Where I can find it at the Liberation Bookstore?
Yeah. You can find it at the Liberation Bookstore, Barnes and Noble, any of the major outlets of books. You may find some of the books that are named, but mostly at colleges. You will find Barrister at Princeton University. You should find the Pyramids and the Carpenters. The Pyramids is those writings inside the pyramid. That's not where the burial has taken place. In the area where the burial was, you get the Carpenters. And that's the two types of texts in the pyramids. And then, of course, you have writing in various pyramids. But the best place, take it if you go, it's of course about $2,400. Take a 2-week trip. It will take a boat, because you're going to have it in front. Take the bus and trips. Go Egypt, take pictures. Carry a camera, take pictures. Or somebody with you, take pictures.
For what you spoke on to us tonight about the order, you got a book written on this subject that we can, I can buy, purchase?
I got many, many books. But I don't speak of them unless somebody asks me. Black Man and I and his family, that's the 800 page one, that's the 1981 version. Africa, Mother Western Civilization, I think that's also 1981. African Origin of the Major Religions. That's another one. And
you go to first
Black Man of the Night and his Family, 1981 edition. Africa, Mother of Western Civilization. The first one was a blue book, the second book was a brown book, and African religions, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. You wrote that?
Yeah.
That's in 1971. That's Africa religions. Some of the other titles, that book has been a number of titles here. Instead, the second page will give you a lot of titles.
Dr. Bennett, I'm certainly appreciative that I've met you for the first time in person. I've seen you for the first time on television. It was a television show called Like It Is, and you had a great discussion with a particular rabbi from this in regards to the Torah and its origin and some other things about it. That was my first time really knowing who you were, and I was certainly glad to have gotten a chance to listen to you. I've attended NYU, and naturally, you have to take various courses. And one of my favorite courses was philosophy. And in reading about Socrates and his relationship in Egypt and all that he had learned and tried, to my assessment, I believe that he tried to bring it back to Greece, back to Athens, and share what he had learned in Egypt. Do you assess, can you Do you assess that is the true reason why they wanted him to kill himself, based on what he has learned, and try to bring him back to Greece?
Remember, the charge against Socrates was, Socrates is an evildoer. He speaks of the things above and the things below. And he speaks of them in a strange tongue. Therefore, he must be burned. The strange tongue in which he speaks and what he's supposed to remember, Socrates was not a real person without his student, without Plato. There is no Socrates. Plato speaks of Socrates, but there is nobody who knew Socrates, only Plato. And he had no mother, he had no father. Plato is the creator of Socrates. But that was Plato's way of speaking what he had learned for 11 years in Egypt. By the way, that's why maybe Killingsley, maybe, what's her name, doesn't like me.
Another question is this. You may mention that Cleopatra was not black, you know, from Egypt. She was not.
Like any of us in
here. Excuse me?
She was not like any one of us in here.
Okay. And it was always my belief, quite contrary.
Because you believe it by hearsay, but you didn't believe by supporting documents. Who was her mother and who was her father? Her father was Ptolemy the 12th, right?
I don't know.
I mean, that's the one stated her father. Now, which black man had him? Which black woman had him? Who was his mother and father? They were Greeks and Persians, of Greek and Persian heritage. You know, in Egypt, you have pharaohs. Who were your parents? When, from the first to the 13th dynasty, you had only Africans, from the first dynasty to the 13th dynasty. The first non-African people who came in the 13th dynasty, and they were Hyksos. They ruled to average. And in the 17th dynasty, they started to be kicked out by Amos. Amos died and his son took over, Cleopatra's father. Then she became queen. When she died, her son took over and they chased out the Hyksos in the 17th dynasty. In the 18th dynasty was a great dynasty, most people consider, of Egypt. There is where you got Akhenaten, otherwise called Amenhotep IV, and many others. In the 19th dynasty came Ramesses II and his group, his father Setaiwan, and others. It was not until the 30th dynasty, the 29th dynasty, that you're going to see the Persians come. That's 525. And they're going to come there and take over Egypt. The 30th dynasty will be the Greeks. The 31st dynasty will be the Romans. And then as the Egypt vanishes, they will start a new period. So these Europeans in Egypt came when Egypt was dying. Egypt had been in power for 5,000 years before the European come there. The Greek came in 332. The Romans in 30.
So who placed her there as the queen of Egypt at that point in time when she became queen?
She became queen under the Greek transition. And she became queen in 47 BC. That's yesterday. That's at 1999 years, that's the Christian period, year one to now. And 47 years more, 2009 years ago. No big deal.
I read that her Persian mother was mixed with African, that the Persian is mixed with the African.
Denzia was never mixed. Denzia's mother and father were Persians.
Pure Persian.
And she was born in Persia and brought to Egypt. They got to tell her not mixed, tell you who she was.
Okay.
Then we could see if she was mixed.
I got another question. How do you suppose that the Europeans adopted the concept of Freemasonry, and how did they make the extraction of the ancient Egyptian mysteries or Egyptian mysteries?
They came into Rosetta, the place in northern Africa, and found one of a stone. And the stone dealt with 22, that's why they can only deal with 22 proven works and make the degrees. 11 degrees, the Aquabarites, are imitation to give 33 degrees that Jesus had. It's the whole Christian thing. And they don't have those 11 degrees, they don't work for. It's political degrees. You pay some money, you get one. I mean, let's talk about what goes on. You don't work for it. You got to work for every degree in the craft. I mean, I'm not saying that to be wrong. I'm just saying, well, we are brothers and sisters here. What we are doing, let us straighten up with each other. You pay for it.
You read somewhere that Muslim and Hindu and Shindu and a Christian can become a brother of Masonic order. Does all that is true? I mean, can
any brother can become it, but when he becomes a god of the craft, he has to give up whatever else he had. Now, any brother willing to put down what he had as against what he don't have, well, is okay. And religion, you see, religion isn't birth. Your mother is the one that created with birth. For instance, I was born December the 31st, 1918. I don't have a birthday. My mother have a birthday. She bought me. And every December 31st, every December 31st is my mother's birthday day. She birthed me. I will never have a birthday. Only women can have birthday.
I'm glad you
yes.
You see, but we take the British thing about birthday day, and then eventually they turn to birthday when men and women can have birthday. What time? Only men had, only women had birthday, and a woman who gave birth to a child had a birthday. She never got a child, she never had a birthday either. You see what happened? We have taken from the woman the child with a whole lot of unique nonsense. For Adam made the baby. What are you talking about? Have you ever seen a man give birth to a child? Even a faggot don't give birth to a child. It's a woman. And we're taking the child from her.
Dr. Ben, this concept of why basically the Christian faith becomes amazing. It's not written, it's not really heard of in America. where Muslim or even Chinese become, even Hispanics becoming into the order.
Yes, this is what happened. In these particular three religions, they forgot that our religion was before them. And all they're saying is Judaism, Christianity, and Islam have a common union in some sense. And that is against all the other religions who were thousands of years before them. And who they copied from. And we said this is the only order. If you're Christian, you say Jesus Christ is the only way. If you're Jewish, you say that's the only way. If you're Muslim, you're that way. And they fight each other. It is not doing us any good. What we need to say, there must be a common law. The common expression is God is love. I wish it was. Then we will love other people. But we talk about God in a hatred mind. That this religion is right, that religion is wrong, this religion is wrong. Hell, they're all right. And they're all wrong. The whole thing is money. This is hard way to hear it, but that's what we're going to hear.
Yes. I'm a little confused where the hype says whether they are Europeans as such or Persians. I'm never really clear.
Well, the Persians are different people. They came in 525. The Hyksos came in 1675. The Hyksos they have at the museum in Cairo, you have some heads in the museum and some heads in the garden. And they show figures that are African as the Hyksos. Herodotus in his book, indeed with them in book 2, speak of the African people. Speak of them as being African people. But then others who speak of them as being another group of people, but they never change the image. So it's up to you.
Sometimes you see, we read in order where the brothers grew up two sides of this compass. And everybody, can you explain the definition of that?
Well, you've got, and the going up you go up the 22 side, the 22 advances, and one side, you got a status right on the other side. The status right is a development of the West, complete development of the West. And the other is taking 22 degrees with the corrupted. From the tablets that they found in Egypt and built the first 7 degrees in it. But then it was only 22. They added 11 degrees, which aren't worked for. They're given out if you satisfy the Big Bang in charge. Then the professor sit down and give you a degree for so much money. You know the big dinner you had.
I've had a discussion with a particular brother in regards to some of the works in the higher degrees from the 14th degree. And his biggest fear is that according to what's written inside this Scottish Rite ritual, that Masonry is a practice of devil worshiping. Yeah. I assess one thing to that, either that he has a lack of faith in his own religion, in his own belief in God, or that he is not he's not reading it with an open mind. And, you know, I tried to explain to them that, you know, you have to be careful of what you read and how you read it and how you consume what you read. You know, sometimes you have to either
accept it. Careful with God.
Excuse me?
And you have to be careful with God.
Well, most definitely.
God is a belief. It's not a fact. A belief. And that's what we get a problem with. When we say, why aren't they a goddess? Women get children.
Men don't get tyranny. Since women get tyranny, why aren't women goddesses? Man's concept. Man's concept. Nothing stops her from being a goddess. She got more logical rights to be a goddess. But we, in our bigotry, can't give the woman, from the time we find ourselves ruling her, we have to give her recognition. And she's crying out for recognition. As a matter of all these crazy things she's doing, putting her dress over her head and all this thing, all her guts out and everything, walking around the street, is to get recognition from you and me.
But it doesn't answer my question. Well, I guess what I was going to ask you is, can you explain why, at least in Scottish Rite, I don't know if you read the two, Scottish Rite 1 and 2, the Blue Ritual?
Yeah.
All right. Why it was written in such a manner that it gives a conception that it is a double worshiping degrees. You know, I myself am a I am a religious man. I have a Baptist faith. You know, my parents raised me to be a son.
You are one of your parents.
Right.
Most of us, but then recognize that you were raised to be something that in our own logic, our own reason, our own justice, our own humanity, it is something else. When we look at a woman, we must ask ourselves, this woman gives birth to children. Men don't give birth to children. And we must recognize her. For instance, I told my mother, when my mother was alive, I had to go in front of her every December the 31st and kneel in front of her with my face up against her womb. And then she blessed me, tell me all the bad things that I did, and give me a few cough now again. And then she ended up by telling me all the good things that I did, and she felt good and she kissed me, I think that was good. And she kissed me and tell me, go on son, make me proud of you. And she sent me out to go. My father, I don't know. She said, that's your father. I don't know. She may be right. If she wasn't fooling around with two men, she right. That's it. And I'm going along with her. But only she knows. But I know she's my mom. Why? Other people were born the same way. You know your father, your mother, and you believe in your dad.
Dr. Ben, who do we speak to make arrangements for your assessing? As you said, prop assessing where you can get more in detail into the request.
I didn't hear you compliment.
I said, who do we make this arrangement with that we can have a meeting here? Where we can get into more details about the craft and the promise.
Hey, man, sitting right here, Dr. Lewis.
Brother?
Yeah.
At the door?
Definitely.
Brother, right here?
Brother with the glasses right here.
Okay, thank you. And I just wanted to tell some of the brothers, one of the books you wrote from Appaloosaville to Giza, he lists a chronological area of the dynastic periods in relationship to biblical time periods. He also shows pictures in that book of the Grand Lodge of Wahset, which I took to deliver a lecture in the second degree on the so-called columns. Good book.
Yeah. Dr. Ben, this is the problem that I have. I got a brother that's, we work together. He came into the order, we got the knowledge and some light. He started reading the Bible. He decided that when he read the Bible, he can leave his brother behind. We left him out. But his theory is that he don't need the lodge anymore because his Bible, what he reads in his Bible, is good enough for him. My theory is that if you're so knowledgeable, why not go back to the lodge and help them other brothers out there if you're so knowledgeable along? So this is the question, this is not the only thing. I ran across a few other brothers that way. Came in, got knowledge, left the lodge, got into the Christian belief. But they will not go back to the Lord because we do something that they say they don't do anymore. But you know,
Lord, we pray. A little bit of knowledge is a dangerous thing. I will not leave a lodge because of that alone. It has to be many other things. As you said, walk with a brother, it may be hard. Walk with a brother, tell them what you think you learned, and exchange and see if it makes sense. You may get more brothers to join you. But if you go and left and don't share with them, you are not agree with you in that sense. You see, because since it's belief we're talking about, we got to share with each other and see what may come in sense. Because none of us, we're prejudiced when we're dealing with belief against belief. So you got to talk. It got to be somewhere when all of us as brothers, Muslims, Christians, Jews, and all other names that we have, can speak to each other. If we don't, we're going to die together. I am saying they've got to be, man, you can't even get Christians to speak with Christians. The Holy Ring is out against the Baptist, the Baptist against the goose mouth, the goose mouth against the tree climbers, and the tree climbers. I mean, gee, you could find in every one black 50 different churches with 50 different names. Don't speak to each other. And then we have the Jews, the Reformed Jews, the Orthodox Jews, the Conservative Jews, Jesus Christ. And then you got the Sunni Muslim and the Guru Muslim and the Judo Muslim and the One Finger Muslim. And
I have a question about the Egyptian religion. What is the relationship between Osiris and Ra?
Osiris is the son of Ra.
Osiris is the son.
Asaruk is the son of Ra.
Okay, so
everybody is a son or daughter of Ra.
Okay.
Because the Egyptian god Ra was the god of all gods. Okay. Long before Jehovah was called the god of all gods.
So is that a parallel to Ra to Sun to Osiris as it is to God to Jesus?
Exactly.
Yes. The Christian God is the son of the Hebrew God.
Right.
And you mentioned briefly about the meeting. There was one particular meeting between Osiris and Ra.
Oh yes, there were many meetings. This one particular is when Ra gave Osiris back his penis,
okay,
after his penis had been cut off by his brother Seth.
Right.
And his wife went and appealed to God to say, please give him back his penis so he can make a child, because the only good God, his brother was bad, is gone, and so the God couldn't give him back his penis, but make it stand up straight, so she could fly over it as a bird and become pregnant. And that's how she got her child.
That's your bliss.
Hovering over the Venus. In Abydos, in the building of Abydos, you see that the whole scene in the rock, and you will see it.
Okay. One last question for me. Thank you for being here, Dr. Ben. The Jews that came, that the Israelis took from Ethiopia, they bring Israel. Why did they bring those?
Well, that's my people. For years and years and years, Ethiopian Hebrews have been clamoring to go back to Israel. There were always some there that the handful of 10 that were. But now they wanted to go in a bigger area. And they demanded of the government from 1947 to the date when they went. to return. The European Jews, American Jews, were not going to have them back here. But they had to, because they needed members, they needed numbers to fight against the Arabs. The Jews were leaving, going to America, South America, hundreds per year. So they had to replace the numbers. So the 12,000 coming from Ethiopia were well received for the moment, but now they are feeling the pain.
Yeah, let's go.
All right, sisters and brothers, one more final question, please. And we'll adjourn this lecture. One more question, please, for Dr. Glenn. If there is one.
Okay. From my readings, I read that the original Hebrews were in fact black.
There is nothing in any readings that says that the people are black or white or gold or brown or yellow or blue. That's your imagination. Nowhere.
The Bible states
in ancient
that no man's wife was Ethiopian.
Where the Bible said they were white?
No, she said that she was Ethiopian.
Well, Ethiopian is showing white.
No.
No. Ethiopian would be jet black, red, white, brown, yellow, and you will see them there in all those colors. And they don't have to be Christians. In the south, you have the people they used to call God, the Roma. You have that's the biggest population in Israel. And they're not Christians or Jews or Muslims. They got their own religion.